ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to the Sherrard Show. I am your host, Sherrard. I hope you're having a wonderful Sunday evening. It's beautiful here in sunny Los Angeles. I hope it's sunny where you are as well. Today, we have an exciting show, ladies and gentlemen. I'm so excited to have this gentleman. He is a movie star, as you see. Look at his appearance, ladies and gentlemen. That is not the most interesting man in the world, but it looks just like him. But this gentleman, he is a photographer. He's a photographer for Playboy. He's also an actor, a model, and then also a chef, ladies. So he's everything all in one. And tonight we're going to be speaking to him on the Sherrard Show, Mr. Alex Manfredini. Is that correct?
It's correct. You pronounce it perfectly. Beautiful. Thank you for having me.
That's an incredible name. But before we get started, the Sherrard Show is brought to you by iHeartRadio. Ladies and gentlemen, you can listen to the episode of the Sherrard Show as well as watch him on television. But if you miss it on iHeartRadio, you can always download the app and listen to it on playback. But it also, you can watch it on Essence Television. Just look at your monitor, ladies and gentlemen. Add it to your Roku, Amazon Fire, and see the best episodes of your life, such as the Isley Brothers, Stevie Wonder, the Manhattans, so on and so forth, including this episode with Mr. Alex Manfredini on the Sherrard Show. So it's time to get excited.
Thank you very much.
Well, ladies and gentlemen, when it comes to Playboy, this man has the job that most men would die to have, to be able to shoot some of the most beautiful models in the world. But also he, if you look at your monitor, he's also an actor. He's also a fashion model and a chef. And he's given out just a little bit of his time today for the Sherrard Show to talk about how he does it and what he has coming up. Welcome, Alex. How are you this evening?
Thank you. Thank you. And thank you, Sherrard. And again, thank you for having me here.
We really appreciate you being on. Now, you're a busy man. Now, tell us a little bit about, first of all, how did you come into being a photographer for Playboy?
Well, that was accidentally, so that one step came to the other one, because when I started with the photography, I started because I was having my background as a chef. And I started working on the food industry and doing what I'm producing on my kitchen, not so just shooting on my studio. So, and then I started working with the food industry for 10 years until they start asking me just to include models on the ads or with the food and all that kind of stuff. And then I discovered that really, I was really good just helping models just to pose and get a nice glamour pictures and all that kind of stuff. And I decided just to make the switch, just for glamour first, then the boudoir. I was one of the first boudoir photographers here in Miami, talking about 25 years ago. And from them, I just developed more like the erotica, that is a kind of job, not that you can see on my magazines, on my publications. So, and from them, so I started publishing internationally on calendars, on Playboy magazine, and books and other projects.
You know, it's impressive. First of all, him being a chef. Now, look at your monitor, ladies and gentlemen. Look at those modeling pictures scrolling down on you. This man has been doing it for a long time and doing it on a very high scale. Now, what is your specialty, first and foremost? What are you as a chef? What is your specialty?
I have different cultures, and I try just to adapt some recipes, with some kind of fusions that I think that works. But basically, on the other side, I'm very conservative, just to keep the original recipes, a traditional Italian or traditional French. For those classic dishes, that you have to prepare it al dente. So that's why I just specializing first in Italian food. I just came back from just to prepare a dinner for 20 people today, and also just I'm not preparing pasta. So that's one of the then, of course, as an Argentinian, imagine that if in Argentina, if you don't know how to grill, so they just nurture you and just to avoid to reproduce it. So that's my specialty, is a master grill. So I made my school in France. So that's why I just love also just to get some of the classic French cuisine. And here in Miami, you start learning not just different cultures and open a little more your portfolio, what you can do, and said, okay, I like this dish from the Caribbean, and just maybe mix it with something of the traditional Italian. And creations are very interesting. So there is a very cosmopolitan place, not just to get that kind of food.
I tell you, ladies and gentlemen, you cannot beat Italian food. That is the food that sticks to your ribs, and that is the food that make that you won't be hungry again after eating it momentarily. You know, I absolutely love Italian food because, you know, the meatball spaghetti, the fettuccine Alfredo, all the things that come along with it. But in Italy, eating is more, is almost like a holiday there. I mean, everything stops in Italy when it comes down to eating lunch and dinner. Is that correct?
Yeah, eating in Italy is one of the most important activities just to do. So everything is dealing with meal in the side. So if you want just to discuss a business, just get a good meal. If you want just to have a family reunion, get a good meal. So even if you have to disagree with someone, just invite them to a meal and just do it too. So yeah, the food in Italy is something that is part of the life, of a really important part of the life of the people.
You know, it's funny. So if I go to when you came to America, one of the culture shock I'm sure you had was seeing somebody stuffing down a hamburger while they were driving, because you don't see that in Italy. Is that correct?
You can see a sfogliatella, no, that is a little pastry, you know, with a coffee, you know, so that's something natural, and also that is delicious too. But the habits has changed also there. So that's why I like just to preserve my grandparents' Italian traditional cooking on, you know, some dishes or how they work it. So personally, I don't like just to use robot or nothing. If I make pasta, I cut it with knife and I do my own like the old days. You know, so I think that is part of how to keep the tradition of those dishes.
If you're not hungry now, ladies and gentlemen, I know you are. You weren't hungry before. I know you certainly are now after looking at all these delicious meals popping up on your screen and talking to this master chef. All right, we'll shift gears in terms of that. Now, when you became a model, first of all, how old were you when you first became a model, Alex?
Well, when I was young, so in my 20s, I was doing some modeling, some runway models too, and some advertising. Then I began just with all my other careers, you know, I was on the other side of the camera. One day also, some of the clients said, Alex, we need a model. And I said, well, unfortunately, I don't have it now. So, hey, can you be my model? So, and I said, well, why not? So, and I started doing the shoot with my clients, and they said, hey, Alex, you really does have the look for a very mature model. And I think that you can be doing a successful career in modeling. So I started switching, you know, from both sides of the camera, you know, and one day they said, okay, I will do it. I will take it more seriously, you know. So, and I started getting my agent, Shannon Matthews, you know, just to do it, my agreements with agencies and all advertising companies and all that stuff.
You know, he's very good at it, ladies and gentlemen. Look at the picture on your screen. We'll talk about that right now, as a matter of fact. Now, there's a picture where it's you standing there holding the camera, as you see, ladies and gentlemen, and then there's a black model and a white model, Caucasian model, standing right there beside you. Yes. That is a brilliant and beautiful shot, ladies and gentlemen. I know the comments are coming. We'll get your questions and comments about this picture. But tell us a little bit about this shot.
Well, that was the promo poster of a reality show. That was a TV reality show that was produced in 2015. Yeah, and it was based on the crazy stories that I was having in my studio. So that, the title was "I Want Alex Job." No, so and the base of the story was just to recreate, you know, some of the most crazy photo shoot that I was having on my studio with real actors and then make it some kind of roller coaster emotional. Sometimes are crazy, sometimes are very, I was having experience that were very spiritual, and also some people use photography as a therapy too. So really, so it's something that 25 years you can imagine everything that I can see in my studio. So that when I was talking with David Barsky, the producer, and said, Alex, that is amazing just to do a reality show. So, and one of the episodes that for the pilot was that when that we have a model from Czech Republic and another one that was from Chicago. And we did that kind of artistic black and whites with the contrast of the two colors together. And then and really all the pieces that was coming, that was very iconic, you know? So, and that was the idea of the show, just to capture me creating, you know? So, and then also telling with my staff the crazy stuff that was happening on the studio and so on, you know? So, and that is where it came in that picture from.
Now, when you say crazy stories, Alex, give us one of your crazy stories that happened.
Oof, well, so maybe we're having one day, you know, so that they come in a couple, I remember, just to do a couple photography, you know, but when I opened the door, it came with another lady, you know, so, and the lady was a little, not the daughter or something like that, you know, so, and I was thinking, well, this was a little weird, but it's okay. So they want you to shoot all three, that's fine for me too. No, so and the lady was sitting on the corner and just very professional looking and everything. In the meantime, that I was shooting the wife and the husband. And really the situation was a little that I cannot understand what is the role of the other person here and just controlling what. So at the end I was learning that the lady was the sex therapist of the couple. And I was having that kind of photo shoot just to, as a part of the therapy, you know, just to fix the problem that they will have. And I said, well, you know, so I started mailing the sex therapist too, you know, just to try to create more of this with them. But that kind of stuff, yes, I was having very funny. No, so
it would have been nice if they clued you in prior to the shoot, huh?
Oh, yeah.
We are talking to Alex Manfredini. He is a Playboy photographer. He's also an actor, a model, as well as a chef, ladies and gentlemen. I see your questions. We will get him momentarily. Again, this episode is brought to you by Essence Television, the network for The Sherrard Show, where you can get the best episodes of your life. Now, Alex, my question to you, though, is this is difficult, but how are you able to keep it business even in the midst of all the beautiful women that you're shooting? Because most photographers will have a hard time shooting all these beautiful women without crossing the line. So how were you able to do it for 25 years?
Well, so first is because I'm focusing on my business, you know, so, and the thing is that I think that the most talented photographer, if they don't have a background just to do in business, you know, so that will be sooner or later that will have to close. So that's what I said. So to me, the first important thing is just to keep my business afloat, you know, so, and for that, you have to have a good reputation, you know, so, and it's something that also affects on some industries that are like adult industries or something like that, that is very common that you start talking because it's a very sensitive marketing, you know, so, and it's a market that is very, very small, you know, so, but to me, results very profitable. So, but when I'm doing my job, I'm doing my job. So that is something that I'm more, as I mentioned, so maybe you have a beautiful girl naked or just to shoot, no, but you are more controlling what this light is okay or the focus or the pose or whatever. So my mind is another place, you know, so during the shoot, you know, so it's just concentration to get the best I can do with the beautiful lady that I have in front. And yes, so that if I last that long, you know, so it's something that that is talked by itself now that I'm doing right.
Impressive. Now, has Hugh, over the years, did he ever stop by and visit you on some of the photo shoots? Hugh Hefner?
Well, we were having some invitation with Hugh Hefner to the mansion. And also, I was having some of the girls that I introduced to Playboy that was working with them. So unfortunately, at the moment that I was doing the invitation, I was traveling in another country. And suddenly it was too late just to when he passed it. You know? So that was just right.
Oh, wow. Oh, wow. You know, it's interesting. Now, we'll take your questions in a moment, ladies and gentlemen. We'll get them. Now, Alex, in this career, being successful as being a Playboy photographer, a chef, an actor, a model, most people would dream of being successful in just one of those aspects, but you're successful in many. Do you feel fulfilled in your career now, or is there something else you still want to accomplish?
Well, I think that is, I'm very polyphasetic, you know, so that's why I want to get a role of chef, you know, so I'm doing my role of chef. So when I'm doing photography, I do photography. When I do modeling, I do modeling. So, but in each one, you know, so when I just make the switch, you know, so I become very, very just focused on what I have to do. You know, so, and I take it not like a bunch of those that is all together. You know, so now the deal is that I'm starting putting all together because some of my clients, they want me just to do a shoot and then they want just to cook a private dinner for them or stuff like that. So there are some crisscross, you know, between some career, but usually it's not. So usually when I'm doing my photography, I have my goals as a photographer, you know, so and just I follow that with my strategies and everything. Then how I want to handle my acting career, you know, so it's completely different, you know, so. And the thing is that just I think that is the key of my success is that I diversify my talents, you know, so. And so then when I have just to be busy with one of them, so I don't let the other one die or go down. So I always keeping my eye on each one of them, just how to get the right channels, just to communicate my messages and all that kind of stuff. At the moment, yes, I think that I'm fulfilled. No, so, but I still have more projects just to do with just like publishing books and doing other stuff like life coaching too. You know, so and. So, but as I mentioned, so with all that I do today, you know, I have more than enough. Not just
oh my goodness. Busy. Extremely yes. Busy individual, extremely busy individual, but very impressive. Now, Alex, let's talk about the perfect shot as a photographer. A lot of people you can find on Craigslist and all of these different sites saying that they're a photographer, but very few photographers really know how to get that perfect shot. And a lot of photographers really don't know how to bring out the best out of their models or their specimens in which they're shooting. Tell us a little bit about how you were able to get the perfect shot.
Well, so basically I have that designed not just in my workshop classes. You know, so I'm starting just planning now just to do in my classes online via Zoom. So just to teach all those questions that you have it, you know, so that, but, just as an advance, I will tell you. So the secret is what is the photography. The camera is only capture light. So the quality of the light that you put on the picture is what it will make the photography good or not. No, so and the thing is that it's like you have a canvas, you know, that is like the model that you have in front. And so use the light like a paint. So if you want just to get a bucket of paint and splash on them, so like a flashlight or something like that, okay, I respect it, that, but it's not my style. So, but if you want just to grab a pencil very thinny, just to create a highlight on the hair or something like that, okay, you have light modifiers that can produce that kind of effect. So as a photographer, what I recommend it is just not go and click the pictures. No, not shoot by because it's free now. I'm starting with a film era. Now that every click costs money. No, so now with a memory, it doesn't cost. So the people think that I can shoot 1,000 pictures, and maybe I have a 2 or 3 pictures that will work. No, I design in my mind the light that I want you to get on the picture because before I get the photography skills, I was an award-winning digital artist. So I received for 6 consecutive years, you know, the GRU Award in Photoshop. So that is the way that creating my artwork, my digital artwork, I was using Photoshop just to add lights and shadows in the way that I love how it looked like. So, and that one, it was one of my secrets that when I started doing photography, I started designing the picture in my mind first. And then use the right light just to create the effect that I was having in my mind. So that is one of the big difference, Why I'm Alex and the other ones are photographers. Not so they are, with all my respect to all of them. But so I have my own signature style on my lighting. And second one also is just, I love just to look for the angles. If I had to jump over the furniture just to make a picture or go to the floor, so look for the angle. You know? So because, you know, so a short lady, maybe if you shoot from the bottom, it will look taller and longer legs. So you have to find, you know, so and most guys with cameras standing there and said, okay, move, and then start shooting. You know? So that is not my way. So, and even those, some models, when they come to my studio and they are familiar with those kind of photographers, you know, that they have to move all the time just to do the shoot and everything. So I said, you know what? So I will give you the positive direction. So you will do whatever I want, because each light that you see here is specifically for some effect. You know? So if you start moving around, just it will not be the picture that I want you to shoot. So and then it's a practice. It's like a pilot. So the hours that you fly, the better that you get your flying. No, so in photography it's the same. If you shoot only maybe once a month, 2 hours, so you don't have too much time just to practice. Oh, if I go down, just to shoot this way, or if I go to this angle and just shooting straight to the eye or something like that. So with 2 hours a month, it will not be happen. So I'm lucky, not that I was fully busy shooting all the time or so, and it was 100, 100, 100. I'm a little more now, more selective, just don't get too many because I'm not that younger anymore. But on that moment, I was having 2 or 3 shoots per day. You know, so they give me all the skills that to practice, you know, just and make a perfectionist on my skills on lighting. As I mentioned, to me, lighting is photography. You know,
so Alex, for example, you know, being used to be a model and do the things, photographers used to say, if they took a roll of 36, you'd be very fortunate if you like 3 of the shots. When I first heard that many years ago, I thought that was kind of bad ratio, because you must not be a good photographer if only out of 36, I'm going to like 3. But is that a true ratio for you as well?
No, not at all. So, and as I mentioned, when today on digital area, you know, so you can shoot, no 1,000, no 36 roll, you know, so just, you can shoot whatever, so just to try to get one. So if I'm not sure what I'm shooting, I don't click, I don't make the click. I don't press the shooter. You know, so even though I have it there, but the light is not right, the pose is not right or whatever, I don't know. I become from the old days, you know, that the lab cost and all that kind of stuff was affecting. You know, so and I grew up as a photographer like that. You know, so just compose first and be sure. You know, so and I remember on the old days we took a Polaroid just to be sure before I was working with large format cameras too. No, so and those that you use for cover for Vogue magazine or extremely detailed. So and in that moment, all the cost of labs or whatever was like every click was costing like only on labs $10 or something like that. So today you make 1,000 clicks. Imagine how much money you are saving. Not so, but as I said, so I prefer just to be completely sure what I'm doing, you know, before the shoot. Because also when I'm doing the shoot, you see the picture immediately on the TVs on the studio. So and if I have to try, your client is also watching the picture and say, well, I don't like it. Oh, I don't like it. So that what I want just is when I make the click and the client look at the picture and say, wow, that's what I want. Okay. So and just to do that, I prefer just to prepare everything before I make the click.
Now, Alex, do you do photo shoots for models who want to do their com card or want to upgrade their portfolio? Do you do those?
Or yes. Is
you do. Okay. Now, yes. Where would they be able to reach out for you to discuss pricing and things like that?
Yes, you can visit my websites. You know, so I have one that is having all my different skills is alexsilverfox.com. Photography one is alexmanfredini.com.
So okay, you can it's right on your monitors, ladies and gentlemen. You can see his contact information right there to reach out to him as well. So it's good to know, because models will be asking me that. I'm sure I'm answering a few questions already that they're going to be asking about that as well.
Yes, of course. Even though, so I was having some help in just a mentoring just to start the modeling career. No? So that's I'm specialized more on the glamour industry. So that's why I went to Playboy and all that magazines. But even though I work with junior talents or that wants to start with a career, you know, so, or models that need to upgrade the portfolio that they really they have, or just to create a new one from scratch. So, and what I do is just to create the different looks, not just a portfolio of similar pictures, you know, so that I will analyze what is the market, the target of the modeling that they want, you know, so, and that helped me just to be on both sides of the camera, you know, so because I know what a person needs as a model just to show to the agencies and the producers, or on the other side, I know when they're coming with some idea for a portfolio, I said that will not work. You know, so that's just let me do my job. That I know what you need.
Well, you know, the thing about it is that being an expert photographer, you can make a break, whether that person gets that gig with Abercrombie and Finch, Maybelline, or whatever, because their comp card with your picks is what's going to make or break them. They're somewhere in Wisconsin and their comp card goes to New York, goes to Milan, et cetera. They don't see that person. They just see what you shot, and you can make a break whether they get that contract or not. Is that correct, Alex?
That is very important. And also that's why I said when I'm starting on a modeling career or the photography career, unfortunately you don't have a portfolio. So the most common thing is that you make what we call in the industry TF. You change your time as a photographer just with a modeling that will post for you. But at the end, that doesn't work. You know? So as I said, as a model, you know, so I prefer just to get the right photographer just to do my portraits, because it's what you said. So maybe people in Wisconsin, what we'll see, you know, so the picture that that friend photographer did for you, and you had to put the note, no, but this was a TF, charming, whatever. So that is the opportunity just to get business. So, and the business, the first visual contact that the producer will have is your comp card. You know, so, or a digital comp card today, you know, so or your website. So the quality of the picture must be extremely important. You know, so that's what my work to it's not because I want to promote my job, right? To any, if you are an actor, if you are a model, if you are any kind of talent that need a representation with a picture, so don't hesitate just to hire a good photographer.
And he's one of the best in the world, ladies and gentlemen. This man right here, he is the best at what he does. Look at some of the shots that's on your monitor. This man doesn't mess around. And his contact information is right below, so you definitely want to reach out to him. Alex, are you ready for some questions?
Yes, of course.
Okay, well, this question comes from Kiara. This is from Kiara from Michigan, Grand Rapids, Michigan. She said she's watched your work and you do some incredible work. She saw your IMDb and the shots you do. Her question is, she says she's a model. How often should she update her comp card?
Well, so if depending how much she will change in the look, you know? So there are people that was trying maybe to start a career with a retro look or something like that, just to target some kind of audience. And maybe on 6 months, they know that they will have more opportunities just to be a sport modeling. You know? So that's why I said, okay, so you cannot go just to see that agencies that are looking for a sport modeling with a retro look. No, so that's why I said, if each time that you decide just to go with your new direction to your career as a model, you need just to make a fresh portfolio. So, and on the other hand, if you're still being the same, so I recommend just to you just to make fresh pictures. You know, so if it's the same activity, at least once a year has a fresh look, because people change from one year to another one. So, and it's good just to good representation. When I have to do a casting just to select model for my shoots, and I see that the pictures, maybe they are 2 years old, 1 year old or whatever. So I say, well, and now maybe it's different and I have that doubt. So that's why I prefer not just to check on the date. You know? So I recommend it every 6 months, you know? So just get a fresh picture or add it to the portfolio, but not from all photo shoots, something actual, you know? So something that shows how you look today. So on the different today that you need some just to post pictures. There are a lot of Instagram models on that need fresh content every day just to keep the audience high. So the demand in our photography for modeling is higher, you know, because there are really a great demand of the followers of those models on Instagram or on social media just to get fresh content. No, so and that's why it's changing a little bit the rule. No, so because even when the people like just to do their surfish with a phone or whatever, so nothing compared with a really good professional picture taken by a professional photographer. No, so if you need just to sell something, you will not sell it with the phone. So you will sell it, you know, by a nice, crispy, and a good message on the picture. No, so. That's why it's not only the technical part, it's just the message, you know, that you create on the picture.
Very good, Kiri, thank you for your question there. This question is from Sarah from Boston. She says she's impressed with your work and love what you do. Her question is, how can she become a Playboy model?
Well, so thank you, Sarah, for your question. And the thing is that first you have to have what it takes, you know? So of course, you know, it's just to be honest with you. So I'm very straightforward, you know, with people that want just to go to Playboy or other magazines. So really, there are some kind of beauty standards for that kind of international publication. So if you think that you are matching that kind of standard, yes, you are welcome just to try it. So. There are different Playboys, this magazine around the world. So you can try just to get the marketing directors or the casting directors of each one and submit your pictures. But in that case, I recommend it. So you cannot submit a picture that is a regular picture. So get a really professional picture just if you want to be serious to be considered by a casting director.
Now, Alex, do you make the final decision many times? I know it's the casting director, but do you make the final decision on what models you want to work with when they send you the photo shoots?
Yes, I do, because it's what I have in my mind. So and what I have in my mind is just to create an image, and maybe I'm looking for some look on a model that is not the typical model. So and I said, it's not the same just to work with this model or with that model. So I want just to create something dramatic or that with a really, I cannot put a model that also will be nice for another kind of shoot, you know, because we will be wasting the time, because my idea of my picture, what I want to create is it will be distorted, because if I don't use it the right model for that, you know, so.
Very good, very good. All right, we have time for last question. This is from Molly. She is from Hollywood. She says she loves the information that you're sharing tonight. Your work is absolutely impressive. Her question is, what is the difference? Very good question. What is the difference between a portfolio and a comp card?
Well, actually, a portfolio is what you show to the. I recommend it just to do it on a website or digital or printed. Not that it was on the old ways. No, so that when you have a meeting with the agency or with the producer, you show what you did. No, so the portfolio show more the work that you did. No, so that was when it was a model just and getting some print ads or whatever. You start adding on the folder. No, and when you go to the, they said, okay, this is all what I did. So that's a portfolio. No, so because it's all your job, your printed campaigns, not that is there. A comp card is the opportunity just to give a good impression with a single piece of print, or now it's digital. So when you send in an email, so you can send it. Can you imagine today? No, so you can target audience everywhere and send it your digital. Comp card, and the digital comp card has to have at least 6 different pictures of different looks that you can get it, and your contact information and your measurements and all that they need just to give a flash of what is your look, what is your possibility just to work with different kind of modeling. So you measure your contact information, your website, or all the kind of stuff, and it's only one single piece. So that is what I said. portfolio. So there was the old day that you were having the folder and then you put the ads, the printed ads inside. So have been replaced by websites today. So it's easy just to get, when I get it published in some place and go and post it in your website. And when you send the concurrent, it's the website there. So the people will see your portfolio too.
Very good. I appreciate you clearing that up, Alex. A lot of people come to photo shoots with a portfolio, but it's a collection of pictures they took on the ocean and none of them is work. They spend a lot of money to these photographers thinking that's going to get them work when it's just a collection of pictures, no ads or anything like that. Well, two questions I have for you, and then I get you out of here, Alex. The first question I want to know is, do you do catering? If people want to have you come out and cook for them, do you cater or do you come out and cook for people?
Yes, I do. So I'm a personal chef, you know, so that's why just what I do. If you want just to hire me, just to get an Italian dinner and you tell me how many people is on your party. So I do. And I get my shows there too, just to make a cooking entertainment tables, you know, so, and I make it participate all the invitations just to cook with me and that kind of stuff. You know, it's part of a cooking show that also I create for them in the middle that I'm cooking.
Very good. And then Alex, last question to you is, you were mentioning something about a book. Are you coming out with a book to talk about your life?
Yes, I'm having a couple of books that I'm drawing, beside the artistic ones with my pictorials and all that kind of stuff. But there are projects just to get it, my biography writing too, and also with all my memories and those, and that it was a very intensive life. So that would be a textbook. No, but also I'm working on a life coaching book, not just with all my messages, and that will be soon on the mail level.
Very good. His information, his contact information is right below. Alex, we want to thank you for being a guest on the Sherrard Show. It made my evening this Sunday conversation. I only have one favor to ask you, Alex. Can you please tell everyone you enjoyed being on the Sherrard Show in French?
Oh, je suis très, très heureux de be the Sherrard Show.
Thank you so much, sir. Really appreciate that. And for him stopping by, if you have more questions or comments for him, you can always follow the email that's below on the screen. And ladies and gentlemen, on the next episode of the Sherrard Show, we have two boxers. They both are claiming to be the next Floyd Mayweather. They will be on the Sherrard Show on our next episode. You don't want to miss them. They are knocking people out left and right, and they say they're going to be even better than Floyd Mayweather. I'm Sherrard. If you want to subscribe, always look at the link below. You can also watch this episode on Essence Television. In the meantime, enjoy the rest of your week. Bye-bye now.
Thank you for joining us on this episode of The Sherrard Show. If you like additional information about our episodes, you can log on to thesherrardshow.com. You can also check us out on social media, like us on Facebook, look at our YouTube video, subscribe to our newsletter at essencetelevisionnetworks@gmail.com. If you would like to get information to the host, Sherrard, you can email him at thesherrardshow.com. Once again, thank you for joining us, and we'll see you next week.